you can get into business in any type of business, but unless you have that first client, you're really not in business. So we certainly understand that and certainly want to help you out. Again, my name is Eric Ogier. I'm the Director of Research and Development here. And matter of fact, Patrick and I were just talking about some things that we are working on currently for our licensees. And so we'll be sharing with that with a licensee webinar next week. But as we go through this today, I want to tell you a little bit about who we are at American Business Systems, how long we've been around, and really who we certainly help out. We help out people that you see like just on the screen here, husbands and wives, partners, wanting to work from home, whether they want to work in a brick-and-mortar type building or again, work out of their house. You can run this business just from anywhere. And as you'll see here, we've talked about whether you can run this business from home, you can be on vacation, you can still run your business. We'll even talk about one of our instructors that comes down and still runs her business while she's here. But we'll talk about that more as we go on through the presentation today. If you haven't already been out to our website is www.absystems.com. That will get you to our homepage here. You can see that there's a lot of information that you can see here on our webpage that it'll take you through into those orange buttons that I just saw there, and that will get you into what's called our virtual brochure. And folks, if you haven't yet got into the virtual brochure, this is the meat of everything that we want to share with you prior to becoming a licensee. We will take you on a journey on everything about the opportunity, how we help you get clients. We talk to you about what you're to expect during the week of training, what you can expect about support, about the technology. We've got some great information here about our technology of iClaim and EMRX. And then finally, you want to get to that final step. That's where all the information and the paperwork is and the contract for the purchase agreement to become a licensee. And then finally, you get the last thing open to you is welcome to the team. So we certainly want to for you to go through that. A lot of people ask us about the Better Business Bureau. And folks, we have an A-plus rating here at the Fort Worth Better Business Bureau, so you can please go out there and check us out there. You're more than welcome to come by our office, come visit with us. We are always welcome for folks to come by. As Patrick says, I've heard him say in our training classes, folks, we have an office that has desks and computers and people, so you're more than welcome to come on by and visit with us at any given time. Well, we just closed out last week our April training, and we're going into the May area, May 20th through the 24th. That is just about 6 weeks from this week. So if you're planning on, thinking about, wanting to get a hold, get into this business, we certainly want you to jump on in here because we've got this class coming up and then one right before the July 4th holiday, which will be June, and that is only 5 weeks after that May class. So you've got a couple of classes that you can certainly take a look at here as we go through the presentation. Let me introduce you to our CEO and founder of American Business Systems and really, personally, a great, great friend of mine, Patrick Phillips. He's written and authored several books, as you see here. From left to right, you see the book that he wrote about 5 or 6 years ago of How to Reprogram Yourself for Success. And folks, if you want help on just trying to get a breakthrough on what you can do in really any business, this is a book that you want to go check out. And you can even ask us here how to get a copy of that book. He also co-authored a book called Wake Up, Live the Life You Love, and then the Cash Crunch, Cash Flow book, which is geared towards and for you as a licensee to help you in your marketing. Patrick's also been featured on some TV shows, one here called The Inside Business with former Senator Fred Thompson, which has been seen on CNBC and PBS and MSNBC and other sites there. And plus, we have that recording on our website, I believe it's in our virtual brochure. But listen, let's talk to the man. Let's get Patrick on the webinar today. And Patrick, it's good to have you here. I'm excited about talking about how we help people coach them to success.
Yeah, well, this is really what sets us apart, isn't it, Eric? I mean, if you think about it, there's other companies out there who teach people through books and courses and things like that. Nobody has a live training workshop for a week that I know of, but a lot of people will do something similar in getting people started in medical billing, but nobody takes their hand and coaches them like we do they?
No, that's what I enjoy probably most of all. I know that we do a lot of work on the front end, and we talk to people, and we take them through demos, But to me, the exciting thing is when we get those folks that have become licensees, have gone through training, and then we catch them on the back end with a demo with their potential clients. And so, to me, this is one of the most exciting businesses I've ever been a part of.
Yeah, I don't know of any other company in America that does what we do, starting with our live training workshop that we do here in Dallas. So before we do that, Eric, I just kind of wanted you to let them know that they can ask questions. You want to kind of point out how they can get to the question box?
Sure, there? Yeah, absolutely. And I mentioned that right there at the front, and I know I had a lot of people kind of come join in here right at the as we got things going here. But you'll see there in that little box there where Patrick is pointing to where it says questions, and you're going to want to click on that, and that's where you'll be able to get in and start typing in your questions. We already have a couple of questions that are coming in already. So if you'd like to ask Patrick and or me a question, this is the place for you to get your questions answered. So just please type in your questions, and throughout the presentations as we get to certain sections, we will kind of stop and pause and answer some of those questions for you. So there we go.
Yeah, good. Okay. And so let's start with this first thing that we want to talk about, Eric, which is probably the most exciting part of what people can involve themselves with ABS, and that's our week-long live training workshop that we hold down here in Dallas about every 6 weeks or so. Wouldn't you say, Eric, about every 45 days or so we'll have a class?
Correct. Yeah, yeah, and like I mentioned earlier, we're going to have one a little bit shorter time because of the July 4th holiday coming up, but as you can see here, Patrick is in front of one of those classes right now. We hold that at that Spring Hill Suites. And Patrick, let's talk about what folks learn during these weeks of training.
Yeah, I mean, we cover so much during this week, and as you can see, folks, it's a fairly small classroom. We can get about 20 people around the tables you see there because we want it to be very intimate. It's set up specifically as a conference room like you see here so that licensees can engage with one another. It's very interactive. We break out into little breakouts throughout the whole thing, and like Eric said, man, we cover a lot. I'm actually showing you here a copy of the student manual, at least the index of it here, as to what we're covering during that week. And I've even got a list here that's a little bit clearer than what you see here. But as you can see, we cover a lot. There's 26 different topics during this week long training. So it's about, let's see, Eric, we start at 8 and we get through at 5:30 now. So I don't know how many of the hours that is, but it's a full week for sure.
It is
and,
a full week.
Yeah. And again, folks, the topics cover everything from just an overview of medical billing. We call it kind of overview medical billing 101. And we go through all of the things that you see here about marketing, all of our auxiliary services. Everything is covered step by step right down to the end of the workshop where we cover support and our jumpstart program that we have and a wrap-up that's just out of this world. Guys, we've had people say they've been to trainings of all kinds, from corporate training situations, and they've never seen anything like this.
You know, I was going to mention that, and people that are on the call today, they're going to think, well, you're just saying that. I really, Patrick, we actually had three people last training that were a part of some big telecom companies. I mean, we're talking about the big boys.
Wireless, right.
Wireless, phone, you know, the cellular people, and one of the gentlemen there was some type of CEO that he and his son had come to this business. They both told me, out of all the corporate trainings they've been a part of, that this one set itself apart from all the rest.
And part of that is due to our instructors, which I want to point out that Eric and I, of course, are involved in this week of training, as are some of our other staff members there from our office. But instead of just having us get up there and blah, 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 here's what the textbook says, folks, I actually pay big bucks for some of our licensees to be flown in and stay there the week and run their business from their hotel room at night. And, of course, they've also got people working for them, like Bonnie Preston that you see here. Bonnie has been with us for about 5 years now. She is a dynamic teacher. You will be blown away by what you get from this lady because she's been teaching for us for, I think she started about 2 years after she became a licensee, Eric, so she's been teaching for 3 years now. And she is a certified business coach at this point. Because during her stay with ABS and her mentorship under me and Eric, she has decided that she wanted to also be a business coach to other business owners, including our licensees. So fantastic lady. You will really get a kick out of her story, having sat in a cubicle for 20 years working as an IT person, making a good six-figure income, and then deciding to get into this business only 5 years ago. She said, Eric, just to be able to turn in that little letter to my employer at one point was just a thrill. And then there's Cynthia Anderson. Cynthia is another licensee we fly in from a different part of the country. Bonnie is from Colorado, and Cynthia is from Arizona. And she's been with us also for 5 years, Eric, both of them, 5 years. And, wow, she is just a dynamic lady. She does many of our webinars, by the way, some of our recorded webinars for our licensees on our licensee support website, you'll see, are by Cynthia over the over the last 3 years. So she's been with us actually teaching now only about 6 months, but she's done some webinars for us and just is, a dynamic, very powerful woman. Now, the fact that these are two women should not discourage any man that's on this webinar, should it, Eric?
No, and I tell you, we got a lot of men that get into this business. So, you know, one thing I want to point out about both of these ladies, Bonnie in particular, you know, she was an IT lady. She didn't know anything about marketing. And Patrick, we know both, you and I, we know that she struggled a little bit. And, you know, she called us up almost in tears going, I don't know what to do. And we come to find out that she wasn't doing anything that we told her and taught her in training.
And that's so, pretty common, though, isn't it, Eric? I mean,
it is,
we've got a lot of people
common
that come through, especially somebody who's owned their own business. Now, she never had, but she just thought she would try some things on her own, and it just wasn't working. So it did take her almost a year to get her first client. But remember, folks, she was working 50, 60-hour weeks. Yeah.
Yes.
And so she did this outside of those hours, and when she's in class, she teaches you exactly how she did that, by the way.
Exactly.
So as you can see from the picture here, it's about half and half usually for, as far as male and female. We do little breakouts where you actually gather around sometimes and actually view what an instructor is teaching you. This is one of our guest instructors showing how to use the Apple iPad when you're demonstrating something to a doctor. And, of course, we pass that around so people can play with it as well. He's also one of our licensees, by the way, that we flew in to do some teaching that time. Let's see. We also bring in an attorney. This is a lady who's been with us for about, she's an independent practicing attorney here in the Dallas area. Just happens to be connected with us and comes in at my expense to counsel with each one of the licensees during the week on how they can set up their business. And, of course, if you want to engage her to help you setting up a corporation or an LLC or a partnership, she's willing to do that, of course. That's one of the reasons she comes in, of course. But it's just a tremendous week, folks. We have breakouts, like I said. We have interaction between the licensees. You'll get to know everybody in that class during the week and be able to participate with them in some of the exercises that we do. And as you can see, it's a wide variety of couples, individuals, male and female, from every walk of life. So these are some of the people, by the way, at the end of the workshop. They're holding that microphone because they're giving testimonials. And you'll see some of those on our YouTube channel if you haven't been out to that. Just go to youtube.com/whyabs, and you'll see some of those testimonials. Anyway, that's a kind of an overview of the training. Eric, you want to kind of tell them some of the stuff that we teach them during that week?
Certainly. A lot of people do ask, so do I have to know about medical billing before I get into here, or, you know, do I have to go to some coding class or anything? Folks, you don't have to have anything. Matter of fact, we would rather take you from not knowing anything and get
right.
you caught up where you need to be, because we do go through all the terminology. We talk about what these scary things called CPTs or diagnosis codes and procedure codes, and we go through all of that, and we take that fear out of what knowing what these particular terminologies are. Then we go through a little step-by-step of how to file a medical claim, and you'll find out that it's really not that difficult. If you can transfer information from a piece of paper to a computer, which is basically what you're doing data entry, in a lot of cases, that's all you're really doing, because all the documents and all the codes are already built into the system. You don't have to go hunting or fishing for all of that. So you're really getting those documents, everything from the doctor that you can input it, and then we teach you the most important thing, how you get paid, how you invoice the doctor.
Right.
So
yeah, and folks, this is we go through this very slowly and yet very methodically to make sure you grasp everything. We give lots of time for questions and answers, by the way. You will be thrilled to sit there and listen to some of the other licensees who ask questions that you didn't think of. That's one of the values of coming to a live workshop like this. We keep it moving. It's very interactive. Like I said, there's never a dull moment. Listen, at the end of every day, people tell us, wow, where did the day go? This is not what you think it is if you're thinking that it's a slow, dull, you know, fall asleep type of lectures. This is an interactive workshop. I'm showing the two main brochures that we have for you as licensees, of course, that can be personalized with your name and logo, of course, that we utilize because these are the two services that we cover in that class in detail. We go into detail as to how you use the iClaim online web-based system, the cloud-based system, and how you can also tie that in with our EMRX electronic medical record system for doctors as well.
And you've got the next slide you got coming up. That's what I was waiting on right there about the iDocs. Now we talked to you about how you can use the technology that we have to be able to see the documents instead of the doctor physically getting you that paperwork and have you having to go pick it up. The doctor can literally scan in every document that they have from their office and get it to you, so therefore that you can take that information and transfer that, again, from maybe one screen. If you've got two dual screens here, input it, look at it on one, input it on the other.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Folks, used to, back when my wife started medical billing in 1987, of course, we were doing everything by mail, or we would drop by the office once a week and pick up an envelope full of all the papers from the doctor that we would need to do the billing. Now, folks, it's all done paperless through this iDocs Now system, which you can read a little bit more about on our website, but I'll talk a little bit more about that later. But, yeah, it's a great system for automating your paperwork, and, of course, it's HIPAA-compliant. HIPAA, that's the Health Insurance Portability Act and Accountability Act, which means it's very protected and the government has approved this system for transmitting patient information through the web. We also, of course, go into we bring in laptops, as you'll see in some of the pictures that I'll show. We bring those in and let you actually get into our system and do the health billing, the health care billing for doctors, and you'll see that live during the workshop. You are hands-on doing the billing. This is the most exciting part to most people in there.
Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely, because you know people are a little concerned about actually how to get into this and a little bit scared because it's in the electronic format, but really it's the easiest thing that we'll teach you during the week, and so we do get you hands-on time. You get to actually input patients and actually process the claim, and again, we do this on like day one, and then because therefore what we want to do is transform you from that into really how to get those clients. But we show you not only on the laptops, but we also show you a little bit on the iPad how that would actually look on the screen. So these are some of the exciting things that you would be able to see in and through training.
Yeah, the electronic medical record system, folks, is actually used by the doctors, and they love it on the iPad because, as you can see, it was designed to fit an adult finger to be able to touch. Just touching little what look like buttons on the screen, the doctor can actually see the patient and interact with them throughout the entire patient visit. It's absolutely the most incredible technology you've ever seen, and you see it live, of course, during the class there. Wow, and Eric, you just touched on something that I guess really is the most important part of the week, isn't it? Even after all the technology and the how-tos and the medical billing stuff, we get into the good stuff, don't we?
How do you get your client? I mean, that's the biggest thing here. And matter of fact, I was talking with a lady earlier today telling her about the training and what we do and how we go about that because, again, we do want to teach you how to use the system. But more importantly, we want to teach you how to get a client. There's where we're a little different than a lot of other people that might be in this type of business because, more importantly, we could show you all day how great a system is, but what we want to do is get you in that position of how to get a client.
Yeah, because let's face it, folks, that's the hardest part of any business. Eric, you would say that no matter what business or franchise somebody starts, getting the clients is the toughest part. So, folks, that's where we come in. That's where
right.
ABS, with 20 years of experience, has learned what works and what doesn't. Now, here's a good example, for example, direct mail. Now, that's been around for a long time. There's nothing new about it. But
correct.
There's some very specific things you have to do to be successful in direct mail. You have to understand, for example, the lifetime value of a client. If you don't understand that clients are worth putting a little time and money into to get them. Look, Eric, what would you say the lifetime value of a typical doctor is for our licensees?
Well, we know that one doctor can generate about $30,000 a year. So, I mean, that could be pretty hefty.
Yeah, in 10 years, that's... $300,000.
Right. So, yeah, that's a big value there.
Yeah. So we tell you the six essentials for effective direct mail that you have to have in place for this business, specifically for medical billing and marketing, and how not to spend and waste lots of money. Listen, folks, I learned a lot of things not to do, and we share that with you in this workshop, because if you try direct mail on your own and you don't know what you're doing, you will spend a lot of money. And even how to find lists of doctors in your area and even their home addresses. Yes, some licensees have been very successful marketing to the doctor to their home addresses because they get mail there. Now, of course, 90% of them are going to throw it away, but we've got a great response rate for our direct mail pieces because of the specific ways we do it. We also have an automated system for sending out cards to the medical providers that you don't even have to think about it. Once you've put them in your database after collecting their information from various other marketing methods, it automatically sends out these cards once a month, once every 6 weeks, however often you want to, and you don't even have to think about it. Now, that's what I call hands-off marketing, and it's terrific, isn't it, Eric?
Absolutely, and that is some of the best ways that we can do it. And here is Patrick showing you a few of the postcards that can go out. We can customize them to whatever you want them to say. On the back end, you can have your signature put on them. And, folks, again, this is just that drip marketing that we show you and teach you in through class. Now, again, is this anything new? No, but it's what we're saying, how we're telling you to do it, and it's over a period of time. I like to ensure the people to let them know that this is certainly not a big sprint where you're going to get 10 doctors in the first month that you open up your doors there.
Right.
But it is a marathon, and you just got to systematically keep in front of the doctor. That's why we show you these techniques here.
Yeah, folks, think of this. Is there any other business, let's take carpet cleaning. Now, that's something you have to constantly advertise or do telemarketing to get clients, right? You've cleaned their carpet, it's clean. Now, you might have them show up again in a year or 6 months, but you don't have a consistent, reliable income. With medical billing, you do, because doctors will continue to see patients every month, and if they see 400 patients a month, let's say, this month, they probably will next month, or it will grow.
Right.
And so, yes, it's very worthwhile to look at this as a long-term, real business, I call it, not a fad of some kind, that once you get that client, that first client, it may take you 30 days, 60 days, 90 days. We've had licensees take 6 months to get a client, have we, Eric?
Right.
And when they do, of course, they're thrilled because now that client is bringing in, $2,000, $3,000 a month income for them, month after month after month. So, yes, it's well worth it. We've spent a lot of money on those marketing pieces that you see there, by the way, over $100,000 on our marketing design and testing. Then there's email marketing. Of course, in today's world, you can't be in business without getting emails. We'll show you how to use autoresponders that automatically follow up for you. And, of course, tips for making sure that your emails get delivered, because some of them get thrown into the junk folder if you don't know what you're doing. And where to purchase targeted email lists of doctors. These are emails, a list of doctors that have opted in for other things that you can email to about your medical billing services. And there's even specific words to avoid in your subjects and the body of your emails that will keep them from going into the spam. So, again, folks, we go into detail. We're just giving you kind of some bullet points here about each one of these marketing methods. But I wanted you to get a feel that, yes, we're very tuned in. We know how to do email marketing. We know how to do it right.
Right. And I think you got a couple of samples there. There you go, of what some of those newsletter templates are going to look like. So we have all of that available, and then we just, again, we show you how to build those, again, to look. You can see this is not just an email. This is like a newsletter, and information sells. And whenever you're able to give the doctor some information, we like to, you know, liken it to, you know, reciprocity. If I give a little bit, then the doctor feels somewhat obligated to at least maybe even talk with me. And that's all we want you to do is get your foot in the door and build that trust, be a very trustworthy company. And this is how we're able to show you how to do that.
Yeah, you build your credibility by being the expert in your field, and we'll show you how to fill templates. This is just a template here that you're looking at, of course. We'll show you how to fill this with valuable information that's available, of course, all over the Internet to cut and paste into this newsletter to send out each month to stay in contact with your clients and show them that you are the person. You want to stay at the top of their mind, right, Eric, so that when the doctor does get ready to switch billing, he's going to think of you, or the office manager, of course, in some cases.
Right.
All right, Eric, this is one of your big things here, isn't it? Trade shows and expos.
Right, and trade shows and expos can be great resources. I mean, how many people, wouldn't you like people to come to you instead of you having to go to them? And this is a great way of getting that activity. And, folks, you got to understand, when you do trade shows, even though there may be 100,000 people there, you're looking for 2 or 3 people that are going to be interested in what you're doing. And so that's where we want to focus on. I mean, Patrick, we just had one of our licensees who just so happens to be a doctor herself down in the San Antonio area, Dr. Sally Combest. She did a trade show not too long ago, and she says this was the best thing that she ever did because out of that she got a couple of clients.
Yeah, and just to kind of throw this in while we're talking about folks, this is, yes, we have doctors who have become licensees. Now, what does that tell you? It tells you that doctors realize that there's probably more money in the business side helping doctors collect their money than there is in the clinical side, and that's exactly why Dr. Combest has decided to move from the clinical side to the business side and become a licensee. So trade shows to me are so great because for just a little bit of money for the booth during a week, you can set that up and have, like you said, lots and lots of people's come to you. So we go into the detail about the purpose of the trade shows, all the types of trade shows that are in your area, stuff that you automatically have to take with you to do the trade shows, of course, and where to find them in your area. We have all kinds of lists, the giveaways and where to find those giveaways that you'll be handing out, and, of course, where to find custom displays. And, Eric, we actually have a custom display, don't we?
Absolutely, yeah.
We spent about $4,000 on this thing.
Yeah, and so instead of you as a licensee having to go purchase a trade show booth, you just rent it from us. That's why we have not only branded everything, as you can see, with the colors, the right logos and everything else like that. This is there for you as a licensee to use, and I'm telling you, it works beautifully.
Yeah, by the way, that is Rhodey there in the picture. She is the lady. If you call our office, more than likely, Rhodey will be the lady who answers the phone. So if you have talked to her, that's what she looks like. Okay, and here's an actual licensee who's actually holding and using that display. You can see it there behind them. It's a big, maybe 10 feet wide, I guess.
Right.
Fills up at least one of those 10-foot booths. This looks like a 20-foot booth here that's being used. Here's a licensee that is using it in one of the 10-foot booths. But as you can see, very attractive, very tied in with all of our marketing materials, so you look like, it's almost like having a franchise, isn't it, Eric? We provide things that franchises don't even provide.
Absolutely. Yep, absolutely. So again, folks, trade shows, if you haven't ever thought about that, they're one of some of the best ways that you can get people to at least come to your booth, even if it's just one or two people that you've got contacts with right afterwards that you can follow up on. So
we did one of these in Dallas a few years back, Eric. You remember we did one, and we had 5 doctors stop by and leave their business cards and say, hey, we're looking for somebody to help with medical billing.
Absolutely.
So we know that it works, yeah. Okay, well, let's move on here. It's 3:30, so we're halfway through the hour. Let's get on to how we coach you on marketing through educational events.
Well, that's interesting that we even talk about coaching because one of the questions that just came in here, Patrick, from Situ, asked, is coaching included in the training?
Well, as you can see, we actually call it coaching because we're actually engaged with you on an individual basis during the training class. But yes, after the class, you also have anybody on our support staff that can coach you in any area, any of these areas even further, and give you more details, point to more resources, and help you with pricing and proposals and all that. So it's as close to having a business coach as anything that I've ever seen.
Absolutely. So, yes, your question is, all your coaching here at ABS is included with your training.
Yeah. Folks, once you've paid your lifetime, we call it a lifetime licensing fee with ABS, we're not going to nickel and dime you to death. We always give you full value because one of the little secrets is that we help you because we make money on the transaction. So once you become a licensee, it's not just get your license fee and then we move on. We're making money as you're making money, so it's a great partnership, isn't it, Eric?
Absolutely. Absolutely. So what Patrick has up here, we're going to talk a little bit about some of the educational things that we help you with, about like positioning yourself as a trusted advisor in this industry. Now, folks, you've got to understand, this is a little bit different than just going out and making a sales pitch to a doctor on medical devices or any other things that might be out there, even pharmaceuticals. You're dealing with the doctor's money, and so you have to know how to approach a doctor so that you do become a trustworthy advisor. And like Patrick had up there, making sure that it's not a sales pitch, but it's truly educational of what we teach you to teach the doctors. That's why I was mentioning earlier about the email campaign, that we show you how to use even the emails to educate the doctors on what their needs are.
Right. And we kind of skipped this. I got too involved in some other stuff there. But folks, it's we're going to show you how to fill a room like this with office managers and sometimes doctors who come to hear your information. That's right. We have helped you put together these educational events using PowerPoint slides and so forth. We have the scripting. We even have recorded ones that you can watch to know exactly how to promote these. And you're educating them on different topics. So we give you a whole suggested list of topics. We show you how to choose the location, how to find a joint venture partner that will help you fill the room, and how to get crowds to your events. So these things are wonderful ways of getting. How would you like to have what was that, about 15 or 20 people there in a room as your prospective clients listening to you for an hour?
Right.
Yeah. So they're learning and getting educated on something at the same time. Of course, at the end, you're promoting what products and services that you have for them. So we go through that in detail and teach you exactly how to do the educational thing. Sometimes we call them lunch and learns. Because
right.
Many times you'll just do this with one doctor's office. If they have, you know, four or five people, you just gather them all around and do it right there, and maybe even bring in lunch for them, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, one of the things that a lot of people don't even think of is to go to their local hospitals, because those directors at those hospitals are actually looking for speakers and people that
yes.
can come in and give information to the doctors, educational events like we're talking about here. So these are some of the areas of, again, where we're kind of a little different and show you exactly how to go out there and go get that business.
Hey, speaking of that, one of the topics that we have is how Obamacare will affect doctors.
Right.
And folks, we got a question here from Eddie that says, do you see or feel or hear of any Obamacare impact to our business? Now, folks, that is, technically speaking, it's called the Affordable Care Act, as you know, where 37 million uninsured Americans are now going to be provided insurance. That's the theory behind it, of course. We don't know how that's going to be fully implemented. But, folks, since that came along in 2008 when we started talking about it, Eric, our licensees' businesses has actually increased.
Right.
I think doctors are even more fearful of having to learn and keep up with all that change, and so they're willing to outsource the billing so they can focus on their core competency, which is, of course, seeing patients.
Right. Absolutely.
All right.
And
of course, along with the education is educational materials. I'm sorry, Eric, I jumped in there. You go ahead.
Right. Absolutely. So here is the book that I mentioned earlier about the book that Patrick has co-authored with a CPA on cash crunch to cash flow. Now, the good thing about this particular book is that This is not branded for ABS. It's not even branded for you. It is written in a third-party voice so that it talks about what the doctors are faced with and why there's no cash flow. And not only do you have this book, but there are hundreds of articles. I mean, Patrick, I think we even showed one last week on last week's webinar about doctors going out of business and going into bankruptcy. And so it's this type of material. This is the educational information that we teach you because, again, we're not outselling medical devices or pharmaceuticals or medicines or anything else. We're dealing with the doctor's money. And so we've got to educate them on this. And I'm glad even Patrick brought this up. Why should doctors outsource their billing? Patrick, I know I mentioned to you that I'm currently working on a new PowerPoint presentation for our licensees on lost revenues due to in-house billing.
Mm.
Now, what better type of educational material can we provide to our licensees?
Hey, Eric, I hadn't even thought of that till just now. Of course, we're going to present that to the licensees on a webinar for them specifically as we do on a regular basis. But wouldn't that be a great topic for one of the educational events for the licensees?
Yes, absolutely.
To take those, yeah, and use those PowerPoints to educate the doctor. Think about it, folks. A doctor thinks they save money by keeping the billing in-house. Eric's going to prove to them that they're losing money.
Absolutely.
By doing that. Yeah.
And it's not only to them, but to the licensees and hopefully to these folks that are on the call today. Because the doctors really are losing money if they're doing it in-house.
Yeah. And part of the educational materials you'll be distributing, folks, are these professionally designed and printed slick full-color marketing brochures that, as you can see, all have a nice corporate look to them. You'll be able to have these printed with your licensee contact information and logo on them, and they educate the doctor on the different types of things that you can do for them. Believe me, they don't know that these things are available, and you can learn about more of these, of course, on our website and by going through that virtual brochure that Eric told you about earlier. Eric, why don't you tell them about this DVD that we developed?
Well, a lot of people ask, well, do we have any doctor testimonials? And so what Patrick and I did a few years back is that we put together this DVD that does have doctor testimonials. And Patrick, I think it's about time for us to do a new one. So this is a doctor testimonial DVD. You can see that we've got it hosted by Hugh Downs. And it just kind of goes through, and you're able to use this as part of your marketing material because, again, doctors like to listen to other doctors. And so this is what we're doing. Again, we're going up on some of the tried and true techniques on persuasion, and this is one of them. You know,
yeah.
I do what other people do because they're like me. And so this,
right, their own
this,
peers are on this
yeah.
DVD. Yeah.
So this DVD is doctors talking to other doctors.
And we get that question from licensees a lot. Well, what makes us stand out amongst other medical billers in the area? Well, here's one thing. They don't have a DVD with, I think it's five or six doctors on here telling,
right,
here is specifically why I outsourced my billing. Now, again, our company name, the licensees who they're actual clients of are not mentioned at all. It's just the fact that these are doctors who decided to outsource and why they did it that is so compelling to doctors when they see this. That's a tool that you'll have available to you to be able to hand out to doctors as well with your name and logo printed on the back of it.
Right. And then part of the other part that we coach you on is how to do business networking. And I know a lot of people know how and maybe have done business networking, but again, there are some specific techniques, especially in this type of business, on dealing with doctors' money that we have to tweak things a little bit. So we do get into this, and we talk about business networking. Patrick, why don't you talk about this? Because you used to own a business networking company, and then we've got Bonnie Preston that's really doing that in the medical field.
That's right. She has specifically zeroed in on that and has produced an audio-visual course on how to do business networking for specifically medical billers. And, guys, this is very simple. Yes, business networking has been around a while, but until you see how we do this, you will not believe that this could be your only marketing method. That's right. Doesn't cost hardly anything because there's lots of places to network out there, and we're going to show you why this method works so well for this business. We're going to put you in contact directly with other doctors. In fact, Eric and I was just talking about that today, that that's part of this medical business networking that we teach, how to be amongst the doctors themselves that network. The best places in your area to find the network groups, and, of course, how to develop the perfect 10 and 30-second commercials that you can use when you're actually given a chance to stand up and tell what it is that you do. Folks, this is not as scary as it sounds because, again, we're going to help you find the professional associations in your area to do the networking in, and you're going to be taught by the master networker herself, Bonnie Preston. And, of course, as I mentioned earlier, Cynthia Anderson has also done webinars for us on how she has used business networking specifically to build her medical billing business. This is invaluable information, folks, and it could be, again, the only method that you ever need to use to get clients if you know how to do it the right way.
Right. And what better way to learn than from people that are out there and have built their business doing that? Again, they're going to tell you what they did wrong and what if they're out there doing it again, what they would do differently. So let's learn and not try to reinvent the wheel, as we've heard so many people that have come into this business. So we're putting that into your bag of tricks. Then we talk about how you use the automated follow-ups. Now, I know we talked a little bit about that earlier with some of those postcards, but again, some of the best techniques that we have is to utilize, again, this drip marketing campaign using these postcards that you just set it and then it goes. And again, all of a sudden, you have completely forgotten about a contact that you had made, and they're calling you and go, when can you come by and visit with me?
And we happen to know that that works, don't we, Eric?
Yeah, we do.
Because we've actually – I'm sorry, go ahead.
I was going to say, it's not just a theory. It's actually a fact that that's actually happened.
Yeah, and we'll tell you that story, of course, when you come to the live training workshop. But Eric, being in our research and development department, actually utilized these cards and signed up a doctor. Now, we're not in medical billing per se as a company, but we did sign up this one doctor so that we could stay in touch with what's going on in the field and test some things out with him, and it's been terrific. Guys, these are not e-cards now. These are real postcards that are mailed through the United States Postal Service with a stamp on them. We have over 15,000 that you can pick from and put on automated campaigns to follow up with your doctors. So wait till you see it. It'll blow you away. Ask your ABS rep if you want to know a little bit more about that too. Sorry, we're having to move on here because we've got
right.
a time schedule. And I do see a few more questions coming in. But folks, if you've got specific questions, just type them in over there. We'll address them as we go through this.
Absolutely.
All right, Eric, this is one of your favorites.
Yeah, I mean, talking about sales reps, I mean, a lot of people do ask about sales reps, and, you know, a lot of people feel a little uncomfortable about going out there and selling or marketing or whatever they want to call it. Folks, it's really just out there talking about the doctor's money. And I know the first few times getting about doing that can be a little nerve-wracking. But so we've got a sales rep program. We teach you how to hire and train them and even pay them how to go out there and do a little bit of your marketing. And so, you know, Patrick, instead of just calling these folks sales reps, I like to talk with people that are already in the industry and partnering with them and having them kind of do a little bit of bird dogging instead of actually being a sales rep for me, because as a sales rep, you got to kind of keep paying those people. So if I can find a way to find someone that's already out there and that's already in the industry, maybe doing pharmaceutical sales or something like that, I can partner with them and then pay them maybe a one-time finder's fee. That's a great way to get out there and market.
Sure, and even the people that have that you have working with you on a regular basis, you know, you pay them on a commission only. So it's only when they bring you business. It's kind of a, you can't lose on a sales rep that's on commission, can you, Eric? I mean, that's just a person who wants to earn money, and you give them a certain amount of money from the billing itself over a period of time. And it's terrific because these are not employees at all. They're independent contractors that are, like Eric said, maybe out there selling pharmaceuticals, maybe cotton swabs and rubber gloves. I mean, there's all kinds of things that are sold to doctors. And there are people, believe it or not, who just love to sell. So, folks, if you don't have the inclination or the time to go out and do it yourself, we'll teach you how to find people who can do that for you.
Right. Absolutely. And then about a website. I mean, Patrick, this is the new shingle that people have to have out on their business now is the website.
Well, the problem is with a website nowadays, if you just have it out there without knowing how to promote it, you could be just like putting a sign up in a cornfield in Kansas and saying, I do medical billing, you know, call me. So this is very important, though, that you at least start out with a very professionally designed website. So we have hundreds of templates that you can pick from that are already pre-designed with all of our services described on them. We put your name and logo on the site, of course, and your contact information. It's yours. And, in fact, when people fill out a form to find out more information, that email comes directly to you as a lead. So it's a wonderful way to get started. Some of them, you know, look different from others, but here's one, for example, just to show you can look as professional as you wish, depending on, you know, your own company names up the top and so forth. But we love that's included in your package. And folks, this would cost you, gosh, maybe $2,500 to $3,000 to have
right.
this website designed.
Right. Yeah, so that's another one of those areas that is all included in your purchase price here. And then we talk about tapping into your own warm market and your professional referrals. Talk about a little bit about this, Patrick.
You know, people don't realize it, but most people know 250 people on average when you start really thinking about the people that you've contacted in your life. And some of those people know someone who works with or knows a doctor or an office administrator. So what we do is teach you exactly what to say to make a presentation, actually, to these people. We've got a little slideshow that you go through. You basically just sit with that person one-on-one, and you explain what you can do for doctors. And of course, if they know someone, you ask them if they know of somebody who can benefit from some of your services. Once they've been educated, then they know now who to refer to you. And, of course, can pay them that referral fee that Eric mentioned earlier.
Absolutely.
That's always a plus for them as well. So you're not trying to sell your friends and relatives like, you know, soaps and lotions and pills and potions. you're actually just tapping into their mental Rolodex.
Absolutely.
It's a wonderful way to get this thing started. The tools that we give you to do one-on-ones with these people, the presentation, the flip charts, the slides for your laptop if you want to use it, is just a wonderful way to start sharing that business with other people. So, folks, I hope you're getting a feel for this live training workshop. Very detailed. We go through all of this and give you the tips and the tricks for each one of these marketing. And then, of course, there's the practice analysis. Eric, tell them what makes the difference between us and somebody just out, you know, selling medical billing.
Sure. Yeah, and people ask again, okay, how do I get my foot in the door? And this is one of them, because we teach you how to do a pretty much of a high-level practice analysis. And all this is just asking the doctor some simple questions or his or her practice administrator or office manager, and going through just some steps here, and we talk to you about how to take that information, then put it into a small little presentation and be able to share that back with the doctor. You can see here on a very professional level, and then let the numbers sell. You know, if you're afraid of selling, let the numbers themselves talk. And I hate that you use that word sell, because it's really just more counseling and coaching here, that you're giving the doctor some information. And this is where the doctor goes, wow, I didn't realize my revenue cycle was in such need. And so those are some of the things that we can teach you and show you. And there, and again, this is one of those differentiators out there, that we at American Business Systems will help you get to that certain level.
Yeah, a doctor likes to think of their money in what they call a revenue cycle. Now, we'll teach you more about that in the workshop, but that's an important phrase. So we teach you to be a revenue cycle consultant. That is, you're going in to consult with the doctor and show them, well, look, here's what it boils down to, folks. You can either show them in black and white that you can either save them money or cost them money. If you can save them money and take all that headache away from them and their staff so they can focus on their patients, that's a win-win. There's
yeah,
no
absolutely.
Selling involved. That's like selling you know, snow cones in the Sahara Desert. It'd be pretty simple.
And then, again, the proposals, the pricing, because, again, this is where it gets into how you as a licensee is to get paid, because you're going to be able to send a nice proposal to a doctor, step-by-step, what their expectations are, what you're going to be charging them on a percentage basis. This is, and then again, we've got templates already for this, and it goes into this nice professional folder that, again, we've already have as part of your marketing material that you get in your business package from us here at ABS.
And this is a very important part of our coaching, folks, because you've never done this before, and we have many, many times. So for you to be able to work with us and our support staff on making that proposal what it needs to be, you know, not overpricing and yet not leaving money on the table, that's very important coaching that you can only get from ABS. Very important in you establishing and starting out your business right. Because if you quote a price that's too low to the first doctor, guess what other doctors that he refers to you are going to want? That exact same cheap price, right? So
Absolutely. We'll
teach you exactly how to do that and how to make that presentation. That's part of our hands-on coaching for you once you get a doctor signing up for it with you. Oh, here's the favorite part.
Doing these demos. I think, Patrick, I think you and I had that epiphany at the end of last year going into this year. This is really what separates us from anybody else out there.
By far.
Yeah, here in America.
There's nothing else like it. Nothing else out there like it, folks. Now, let this sink in. You want to show the doctor the latest technology and what you can do for him in his revenue cycle. But doctors are very interested, by the way, in the latest technology. So you say, look, I've got some technology I want to show you. It's cloud-based. It has everything built in together. I want to show this to you. It's a, you know, no-obligation demo. And guess what? Our staff do the demos for you. Our technology partners actually get online and with the doctor, using technology like we're using right here called GoToMeeting, we show them our system, our web-based system, and the electronic medical record system live.
Right.
Yes, we're talking to them. They can ask all the questions they want, and they can, and we can hear what they say throughout the whole thing, which is wow.
Yeah,
wow.
Absolutely.
I mean,
wow.
Lots of wows, isn't it, Eric? And, of course, you, as the licensee, can be there as well, sitting in on the demonstration from your own home or office, watching what's going on between us. And sometimes the very last thing they ask, Eric, is just what do I do next, right?
Absolutely. And you know, one of the things that I think, again, that sort of separates us out with these demos is because, Patrick, you and I both know that the doctors have set probably 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 to 10 demos with other pieces of software.
Oh, yeah.
And really the difference of what we do outside of them just looking at another piece of software is this. We focus it on their dollars. We show them how we use the system to increase their cash flow. So we are constantly, throughout the demonstration, talking more about how we're able to increase their cash flow. Instead of just showing them the bells and whistles, we actually show them how that impacts their cash. That's the difference.
Right, how our live real-time eligibility, for example, will keep them from spending time with patients that are not even eligible for coverage from their insurance company. How our real-time error checking and scrubbing keeps them from having claims rejected by the insurance companies. These are the things that when I say they say, wow, it's kind of like we can't see their head, but if we could, there'd be little light bulbs going off above them, wouldn't it, Eric? That's
right.
What the wow means, because they get it. They get it, and they realize, oh, I shouldn't be letting my staff do this. This is not what we should be focused on. And really, it's a light bulb that goes off. You can tell it. You can hear
right,
it.
Absolutely. You really, really can. Well, Patrick, I know that you got a lot of slides to go here, so maybe we can go through a couple more of these. We've got about 7 more minutes to the top of the hour here.
All right. I'm going to zip through these if you guys don't mind.
Sure.
And, hey, we're looking at the question box, so as they come in, let's try to just jump in with some of those. Oh, here's one right here. Manish says, with all this marketing methods and support from you guys, I don't think anyone can fail to do billing business. But what's the success rate for ABS licensees? Oh, well, Manish, we love that question, don't we, Eric? We
Absolutely.
Get that a lot. And sometimes it's a hidden question. What people really mean is, what's your failure rate?
Right.
You know, they want to know, if I'm going to invest this kind of money, I want to know what my failure rate is. Well, here's the rate. It's 100% success for people who follow what we say to do. Now, if
right.
you're going to go out after doing our training and try stuff on your own, I can't guarantee that. All I can
right.
guarantee is that if you do what we say and just don't give up, continue to stay in contact with our support people until you get that first client, that's all you really need to do. Folks, we've had licensees say that they've used one of these marketing methods to get a client, And once they did that, they never had to market again. Why is that, Eric?
Because the doctors themselves are become your best sales reps.
That's right. They refer you to their fellow doctors because you've done such a good job for them. So great,
right.
Great question, Manish. Thank you. After getting a, let's see, here's from Ron. After getting a client, do you provide coaching in developing a contract and establishing service expectations and agreements? Yes. Ron, we didn't make that clear there, but in that proposal is also the agreement itself. We have a templated agreement that you can fill out. And so we'll work through that, all of that with you to make sure that you feel comfortable when you present that to the doctor. We don't miss a thing. Yeah.
And then you want to take this last one here from Liz. Liz is asking the question about, do we offer a complimentary iPad to them as they do sign up? So, Patrick,
I'm glad you're thinking like that, Liz, because that's exactly what we recommend licensees do. Now, we haven't talked about this because this is kind of the details. We're trying to kind of give you the 30,000-foot view today. But, folks, part of what you're going to be taught is to get a setup fee, a training and setup fee, we call it, for each doctor. That can be and is averaging somewhere around $1,500 to $2,500. So you guys who know that an iPad costs around $500, and the Mini is now $350, you can give away an iPad because that setup fee is all yours. So if you've got a setup fee of $1,500 even and give away a $500 iPad, you've still got $1,000. And, folks, there's really very little cost for you to get up and running with each one of your clients. So great idea, Liz, and a lot of licensees have done that and are doing that right now. Yeah. She also says, selling is a numbers game. How many contacts do you recommend that we market to on a daily basis when we're starting out? Well, Liz, that all depends on a lot of things. Depends on your time, whether you're full-time or part-time. It also depends on how much time you have to work with other people who might be your referrals, like doing your business networking. But as I told you earlier, one of our licensees who comes down and does the training, Bonnie, was working 50, 60 hours a week. So she still got a client. That means that we're going to teach you how to do, outside the regular 40-hour work week, what you need to do to get a client. So, again, it just depends on the person. All right, so we also coach you, as you can see, folks, on setting up and running your new company. That includes the type of entities that you should consider setting up, how to name your business, very important that you name your business correctly, your business address, how to set one up that's not your home address, business cards, do's and don'ts, and, of course, tax advantages in this business. Again, the attorney that I bring in to help you with all that will share some of that information as well with you. But we have a whole session on the basics of setting up a business if you've never been in business. And then, of course, folks, we teach you to use our auxiliary services, not the billing, but the other services like Choice Pay, to open the doors, Quick Collect. These are all services. We'll go into detail in the training, but you can also learn about these on our website. Just ask your ABS rep about any one of these, and we can go into detail about any one of these. Auto cards, iDocs, now we've mentioned some of those, of course, during this webinar today, and then, of course, Audit Guard. So, and CodeWrite, I forgot about that. These are all services, folks, that open the doors and give you such an advantage over a billing company in your area that's just doing, you know, medical billing. That's all they do.
Excellent. And then let's go through this last little part here.
Yeah.
I think we've got enough time.
Sure.
Because not only do you get the training beforehand, you get the training afterwards. And, again, this is where a lot of people need coaching. And this, as a matter of fact, Patrick, we're going to do a ongoing live training, some workshops this next Tuesday with our licensees via web. So, but you get DVDs at the end of the training. The topics that Patrick's got on the next slide there is all the different topics that basically we go through in the training workshop, and then plus you got it on DVD.
And then, of course, guys, we give you what's called lifetime support. That literally means that you, as long as you're an ABS licensee, meaning you're sending claims through our system, you have lifetime support from us. It never ends. It's not 1 year. It's not 2 years. There's no charge in the future for it. It is lifetime, by phone, by email, by live chat, right across our website. You'll see it right there when you go to the licensee website. Now, you guys can't get to this one. This is specifically for our licensees, but look up in the upper right-hand corner. As you can see, we give you the phone number. We give you the email button that you can click on, or you can click the button for live online chatting with our support people. It doesn't get any better than this, and folks, there are franchises that cost $250,000 that don't have this type of live support. Then, one of the links on this site for our licensees is our ABS Licensee Forum. Look at this. Eric, I don't know if you've been out there lately, but look at all the recent posts out there by yours truly and some of our licensees and instructors that have kept this thing active. Folks, you can interact with all the other licensees across the nation for ABS that are logging into this. Leave questions, leave comments, gives resources, tips on how to close deals, success stories. There's wonderful data here that, again, is not provided by even some of the most expensive franchises that are out there. We spend the time and money to make sure that this is very interactive for you guys because when you're successful, we're successful. All right, well, finally, we got through all that, Eric. It's 4 o'clock.
we got through all of it. And, folks, I want you to feel comfortable with us here at American Business System. So we have this 100% money-back guarantee that if at the end of the training workshop, for any reason, you do not feel like this business is right for you, just simply tell one of us here at ABS, and we'll arrange for you to receive a full refund of your licensing fee. Patrick, you want to talk to them about where that licensing fee is being held?
Yes, our attorney has set up a special trust fund that the funds go into when you first pay us that license fee. They are held in that trust fund until that training week is completed. In other words, we can't even get our hands on that license fee until you have decided that that is all, exactly what you thought it was going to be. And if it's not, then you ask for your money back. Now, people ask us all the time, how can we do this? Why do we do this generous a guarantee? It's because we know what we have, folks, and by the end of that week, you will know as well what we have and whether this is really all that we've made it out to be. So that's the fairest way I know to do it. I don't know of any other company that does that, Eric, so that's why we do it. That's the way I treat people in business, the way I'd like to be treated, and that's the way I want to do it. I would not want to commit myself 1,000% until I'd seen exactly what that training is all about and if it's what they say it is. So
absolutely.
Here's the dates once again, guys. I hope I can see each one of you at one of these upcoming live training workshops. If not, just be on the webinars every week until you decide this is right for you.
Absolutely. Well, Patrick, thanks for taking out your Wednesday afternoon. Folks, so again, we look forward to seeing you hopefully at one of these training workshops.
Yeah, thank you, Eric, for being on here as well. Bye for now.
Absolutely, thank you.
See you next week.
Bye-bye.